In this video, you're going to learn how to use Ahrefs to find the perfect keyword for your next blog topic idea. If you don't have a blog topic idea, click the link in the description below and it'll take you to my SEO case study where I walk you through step by step exactly how I went from zero to over 1,000 daily visitors in less than 6 months. And if you're already reading the blog post and you skip the section on blog topic ideas, what are you doing? Quit skipping sections. Let's get started. All right, let's dive right into it. So head over to your Ahrefs account. If you don't have one, you can also use Google Keyword Planner, but I prefer Ahrefs because it's more accurate and it also gives you keyword difficulty information, how difficult it is to rank for a given keyword. And it gives you so much other stuff. It's a really amazing tool. So head over to Ahrefs and go to your Keywords Explorer tab. Now on this page, you're gonna wanna type in your general broad match keywords. So for example, sticking to our SEO case study, for this post on RV accessories, my general topic idea was just kind of must-have RV accessories, cool RV gadgets. I didn't really have a defined keyword, so I just started with the general broad match RV accessories. And then search for that. Now, a quick word of warning, you're typically not going to target the first keyword that you try, so keep that in mind. I just happened to really love the idea of the keyword, and it just worked out really well, so I got lucky there. But it'll bring you to this overview page, and here it's going to show you your search volume. That's how many searches your keyword gets per month. It shows you return rate, which is just how many people return to the search page after clicking on a result. So if I clicked on the position one result and then I hit the back button, that would count as a return rate. Clicks is the number of actual clicks that go on the search results. So if they type something in and then click, that's a click. Whereas if they type something in and then don't click, it doesn't show up here. And it also shows you the breakdown paid versus organic. So 63% of the clicks for RV accessories go to the organic results, and it'll show you the trend over time. Then keyword difficulty is the big one here. So this says it's a 28, and that goes on a scale of 0 all the way to 100. Basically, that's Ahrefs' way of saying how many backlinks you'll need from other websites in order to get on page one of Google. So it says you'll need backlinks from about 33 websites to rank in the top 10 for this keyword. Keep in mind, it's not 100% accurate because my article has backlinks. It has 138 backlinks, but only from 31 unique websites. So maybe because I have multiple backlinks from each website, that pushes this number down. Maybe because of my overall domain authority. There's lots of things that could change that, but generally this is pretty accurate. So from this page, in order to find keyword ideas, we're going to go over here where it says keyword ideas. All of these different things are different ideas you can get. So if you just click on all, it'll give you everything. Typically, I find that if you click on all, it gives you too much stuff and it's too irrelevant. So I like to do either phrase match or having same terms or also rank for or search suggestions individually and look at them one by one because it's typically more accurate that way. And this newly discovered, that's actually new. I haven't even used that yet. So we're going to check that out. So I'm assuming this is just stuff that's newly discovered from October to December by Ahrefs. So simple enough, pretty cool. But I like to go into phrase match for the first search. So that's going to give you, literally it'll have that exact keyword in there. So it has RV accessories in that order in every single one. So it'll show you the keyword difficulty. It'll show you the cost per click. A high cost per click, by the way, is a good thing because it typically means that people are willing to pay more to get clicks when someone searches that keyword, which means they're making money from it. So that's always a good thing to target. And it shows you the monthly search volume, again, the number of clicks, and CPS and RR. I wouldn't worry about that stuff too much. That's the return rate. And then the parent topic is the keyword that's kind of like the biggest, baddest keyword you can target. It gets the most searches per month, but it's also typically the most difficult to target. So in this case, I got lots of ideas. We've got boat and RV accessories. That's okay. Best RV accessories. That's actually the original keyword I was targeting, and then realized that just RV accessories was a better one to target. So RV accessories, must have, fun RV accessories. These are all good topic ideas. So fun RV accessories you have to have this summer, or must have RV accessories that every RV owner needs. So use these as a way to refine your topic idea to be more pointed and more focused on your primary keyword. And then again, you can go through having same terms, that it has RV and accessories, but not necessarily in that order. RV kitchen accessories could be a good article idea. RV camping accessories. So you get the idea here. You're basically just looking for the best keyword that fits in with the topic idea that you have, so you can refine it and focus on one keyword. Then once you're done with that, you're going to do LSI keyword research, which I'm going to talk about in the article below this video. So if you're watching this on YouTube, definitely check out the article in the link below, and leave comments or questions if you aren't sure about anything, or if you have some topic ideas but aren't sure if you're really picking a good keyword or not. I answer all my comments, so definitely leave one below, and I will talk to you guys soon.
So now it's over to you. What are your favorite ways to use Ahrefs for keyword research? And as always, if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks for watching.